Hello fellow Guardians, welcome on a new week on Destiny and a new GM Nightfall. This week is about the GM Nightfall heist battleground the Moon, where we gonna talk about what champions there are and where they are going to spawn. In the Nightfall, the threats and search with shield you will encounter and where in this Nightfall the best places to stand are for the best survive chances. We also going to talk about what weapon it is this time in the GM and what the best perks are for PvE and PvP and what builds my fellow guardians have used for making this GM to a good end. So, let's start! As soon as you spawn, it is best to stand on the left side of the mountain, where you have a good overview of the battlefield and where you are reasonably well covered and where the watchtowers cannot detect you. As you can see, there are Witch's Solar Shield and Knight's Arc Shield. Try to first kill the witches and then the knights, but be careful, there are also 4 barrier knights between the enemies. After you killed enough enemies, there will spawn a Dead Tongue, who you need to see as a priority now, because if he can sing, then more enemies will spawn, and then your super and abilities will not work anymore, till you kill them. If you killed all the enemies, there will spawn in the distance some more enemies, where will be also 3 barrier knights and 1 unstop ogre. Make sure you first kill all the champions before you kill the miniboss, because if you kill first the miniboss before the champions, then will all enemies despawn and you will not have your platinum reward. Now that the vault is open, you can go further to the next encounter and we can talk about the build me and my fellow guardians used and which weapons we used. We also can talk about which mods there are in the Nightfall. The Braytech Offspray Adept is a rocket launcher that we already have a few seasons at the Nightfall. In my opinion, the best perks for PvP and PvE are the same and are Heart Launch, Black Powder, Cluster Bomb, Chain Reaction, the Masterwork is Blast Radius and the mod is Adapt Projectile Speed.
Setting that perimeter tower to friendly. You're welcome.
The build I use is Nightstalker Invisible. I use Markmans for weapon reloads, triple jump, snare bomb, vortex grenade, the Aspectar, Trapper's Ambush for invisibility of the smoke bomb and the dive melee, vanishing step for invisibility when you dodge. And fragments are Echo of Starvation for devour when you pick up an orb, Echo of Dominance, Echo of Persistent for longer invis, and Echo of Obscurity for when you do a finisher to go invis as well. Exotic Graviton Forfait for even longer invis when you are invis for 11 seconds. Talk about the build my fellow guardians use. Pro Street Tegan uses Golden Gun Selection Lighthawk, with Polaris Lens for barriers and on stops to stun, and with Radiant Explosion on his 4th Precision shot. Necron used the Lucky Pants build with Malfeasance for DPS on minibosses, bosses and champions. The perks that are active in this Nightfall are Dread is Void, Surges are Strength and Solar for 25% more DPS and Snipers for 25% more DPS. Now that you went through all the hallways and killed all the small enemies, you arrive at the hardest part of the GM the ghost protecting. The best thing to do is that you play from the space where you enter at the stairs. You first kill all the enemies and after you kill them, the Invis Hunter starts the encounter, and then there will spawn enemies at the door. Mostly small enemies and scorn captains with solar shields. Once the ghost is at 25%, there will spawn two unstopped ogres that you need to kill first before you can activate the ghost again. Once the ogres are dead, the hunter will go invisible again and activate the ghost and stays invisible and around the ghost. Once the ghost is 50%, there will spawn two unstopped ogres again. When you kill them, the hunter needs to be invisible again so he can activate the ghost once again at 75% and 85%. Important to know is that you need to be sure the unstopped ogre is dead before the ghost is 100%. If you don't do this, all the enemies will despawn and you will miss the platinum reward.
Yeah.
outposts are clear to move.
Now that you went through the hardest encounter of the GM, you arrive at the vault where at the back of the safety encounter bosses. Now you have two options. Option 1 is that you jump up on the platform and you wait there till the time is over. Keep in mind if that you choose this option, you have to deal with one unstopped ogre and one barrier knight. You can also choose option 2. With option 2 you're going to get the two orbs where you can shoot the stamp in pieces. The first option is the safest, but the slowest. The second option is more daring, but you will be rewarded with an ammo crate behind the door, what makes that you have max heavy and special for the whole team.
Hayati, here we come.
Now at the boss encounter you have a nice G-spot. Before you start the encounter, the guardians that don't have invis will jump on the left pipes in the back of the room. But be careful that you don't jump too far, because then you will die immediately. Now that you stand on the pipe, you jump up on the pipes that go diagonally upwards. Once you are totally up, you jump to the metal frame that is hanging on the roof and you run a little further until you fall between two pipes where you will stand on a platform far away from the enemies. Just keep in mind that you can be hit by snipers that are on the left and the right side of the room. But from up here you can start to DPS the boss till he has 50% life left. Then there will spawn two unstopped ogres in the middle of the room. Kill first those unstopped ogres and after that you kill the captains that have arc and solar shields. Once the first captain is killed, the Invis Hunter can jump down to get the orb that the captain drops if he dies, and put it in the tower in the middle of the room. This has to be done 5 times. Very important is that the 2 guardians that are up kill all the captains and that the hunter stays invisible so he can just pick up the orbs and put them all in the tower. Once the 5 orbs are put in the tower, the last DPS on the boss can begin. Once the boss is killed, you completed the GM Nightfall Heist Battleground the Moon and you can receive your reward.
Digging in extra files to these data packages, Anastasia. Literature, philosophy, a necessary drill.
Vespian's not just protocol and process. Treating him like that won't be rebuilding him. It'll be remaking him into something else.
So, good luck, fellow Guardians, and congrats with your Gilded Seal Conqueror. See you next time with more GM Nightfalls. Bye!